Hello dear students, welcome in our video lecture of some basic concepts of chemistry. In the previous video we have discussed about normality and the relation between normality and molarity. Now our today's topic will be parts per million, ppm. Okay, so take your notebook and pen with you and let us start. The word ppm stands for parts per million. This is parts per million. That means some parts out of a million. When the concentration of solution is very small or having very small value, then concentration is measured in ppm. So the pollutants present in our air and water are measured in ppm because their concentration is very low. So when concentration is having very small value, then ppm should be used as the term of concentration. Now let us define the word ppm. Mass of solute in milligram. Here the word milligram is most important. Mass of solute in milligram. In the previous definitions of molarity, molality and normality, there were mole or equivalent mass, but here only mass. Mass of solute in milligram present in, mass of solute in milligram present in 1 liter of solution is known as ppm. Mass of solute in milligram present in 1 liter of a solution is known as ppm. That means if we write the formula of ppm, then it will be like this. Mass of solute in milligram upon volume of solution in liter. This is the formula, and from this formula you can easily derive the unit also, milligram per liter. There will be, that will be the unit for ppm. Now let us convert these quantities into this mass will be converted into gram and volume will be converted into milliliter, because in our laboratory mass is mostly measured in gram in all the formulas and volume is always measured in milliliter. So we will convert it into our familiar units. But for that, just remember this. Milli, centi, deci, deca, hecto, kilo. आपने बनी क्या सी है पहले? तो अन्य याद करो, milligram. And I want to convert it into gram. Now milligram and gram. Here it is gram. So if we convert milligram into gram, then milligram is the 1000 times smaller unit than gram, because 10 to the power minus 1, 10 to the power minus 2, 10 to the power minus 3. So here if you write gram, then the actual unit that was present according to the definition is milligram, but we are going to write it in gram without changing the definition or meaning of the definition. Therefore, if we write gram, that is the unit which is 1000 times greater than the unit present in our definition. तो ये मदद में रखवाने का अपने हजार गणों मोटो यूनिट लिखवाना चाहिए आया। तुम लिखी लो दो अजी। Mass of solute in gram. Definition प्रमाणे तो milligram हो जो according to definition there should be milligram, but I am going to write it as gram. तो एमनम ना चाले इजे difference में लिए वो से एन हमारे indicate करवो पड़ से ये आप रहना करी। अने volume of solution. According to definition, volume should be in liter, but I am going to write it in milliliter. Now you know very well, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. So there should be liter, but I am writing milliliter. That means I am writing a unit that is 1000 times smaller than the unit present in our definition. Definition માં જે unit છે એના કરતા હું 1000 times smaller unit લખું છું. તો મેં કર્યું શું ખબર? At the numerator, the unit I have written is 1000 times bigger than the unit present according to definition. But at denominator, I have written the unit which is 1000 times smaller than the unit present in our definition. So, આને 1000 times bigger unit લખો, આને 1000 times smaller unit લખો. That means the unit I have written here is 10 to the power 3 times larger. And here the unit I have written is 10 to the power 3 times smaller. So the total difference occurred over here is 10 to the power 3 and 10 to the power 3. So total difference is 10 to the power 6. So to equal both these formula, I have to multiply this formula with 10 to the power 6. Because this is the difference between these two units. According to definition, unit was milligram and liter. But I have written in gram and milliliter. So, if I want to make the proper meaning which definition shows, then I have to multiply this formula with 10 to the power 6. Because this is the total difference between these two units. હોવું જોતું તું મિલીગ્રામ, મેં લખ્યું ગ્રામ, 10 ટુ ધી પાવર 3 જેટલું મોટું. હોવું જોતું તું લિટર, મેં લખ્યું મિલીલિટર, 10 ટુ ધી પાવર 3 જેટલું નાનું. તો ટોટલ ગેપ પડ્યો 10 ટુ ધી પાવર 6 નો. એ ગેપ થી આપણે મલ્ટીપ્લાય કર્યો. સો ધીસ વુડ બી અવર ફોર્મ્યુલા ઓફ પીપીએમ વિચ વી આર ગોઈંગ ટુ યુઝ ઇન અવર ન્યુમેરિકલ પ્રોબ્લેમ્સ. તો દાખલાઓ કે એમસીક્યુ સોલ્વ કરવામાં આપણે પીપીએમ ના આ ફોર્મ્યુલાનો જ ઉપયોગ કરશું. પીપીએમ પણ 12th સ્ટાન્ડર્ડમાં તમારે સોલ્યુશન ચેપ્ટરમાં ઘણી બધી જગ્યાએ ઉપયોગમાં લેવું પડશે. અત્યારે શીખશો એ બધે કામ આવવાનું છે. સારું, તો પીપીએમ નું ડેફિનેશન અને આ ફોર્મ્યુલા લખી લ્યો, પછી આપણે એને લગતા એક્ઝામ્પલ જોઈએ. ઓકે, નાઉ લેટ અસ સી સમ ન્યુમેરિકલ પ્રોબ્લેમ્સ રિગાર્ડિંગ પીપીએમ. નાઉ સપોઝ ધી ક્વેશ્ચન ઇઝ find the PPM of a solution which contains 2.0 into 10 to the power minus 6 kilogram of sugar present in 2 liter of a solution. Now this is the question and we are going to find the value of PPM for this solution. So the first thing is we are going to write the list of the given data. Now here we are asked to find the value of PPM that we are going to find, and it contains this much kilogram. Now look carefully the unit of our solute. Solute is sugar and it is given in kilogram unit, and the value is 2.0 into 10 to the power minus 6. So here mass of solute is given 2.0 into 10 to the power minus 6 kilogram. But we are going to use a formula in which mass will be in gram. So we have to convert this into gram, and to do so, if you want to convert this kilogram into gram, then we have to multiply it with 10 to the power 3. This will be our gram. So 2.0 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 6 plus 3, that is minus 6 gram. So this much gram sugar is present in our solution, and volume of solution is 2 liter. Now we are going to convert it into milliliter, that means 2000 milliliter. Okay, now let us apply the formula. PPM is equal to mass of solute in gram upon volume of solution in milliliter, and डोंट फॉरगेट टू राइट 10^6 ओवर हियर। जो आप भूली गया तो दाखला नो जवाब खोटो आवशे। एक बात तो नक्की कि इन ऑल फॉर्मूला मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट शुड बी ऑलवेज इन ग्राम एंड वॉल्यूम विल ऑलवेज बी इन मिलीलीटर। ये तो नक्की ज खाली आ एक याद रखवानुं छे। ओके नाउ लेट अस पुट द वैल्यूज। मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट दैट इज 2.0 इनटू 10^-3 डिवाइडेड बाय वॉल्यूम ऑफ सॉल्यूशन दैट इज 2000। सो आई कैन राइट इट लाइक दिस 2 × 10^3। 2000 मींस 2 × 10^3 multiplied by 10^6. Now, here these two will be cancelled. So, if this will be cancelled, then there is 1 multiplied by 10^-3 multiplied by, if this 10^3 goes to numerator, then it will become 10^-3, and we have already 10^6. Now, 10^-3 multiplied by 10^-3 will give us 10^-6. And 10^-6 multiplied by 10^6, that means it will be 10^0 minus 6 and plus 6, so it is 0, and 10^0 is equal to 1, so our answer is 1. So ppm of our solution is 1. So that's all for this question. So you can find the value of ppm for any solution if you are having the value of mass of solute and volume of solution. So pause the video and just write down this question. Okay, now let us see one more example. How much gram of glucose is present in 5-liter aqueous solution if the solution is 2.5 ppm. Now this is the question. Here ppm is given and we are asked to find the mass of glucose, that is mass of solute. So first of all, ppm is given 2.5 ppm. Then volume of solution is also given, that is 5 liter, so it will be 5000 milliliter. We have to convert it into milliliter, and we are asked to find the mass of glucose in grams. So again, let us write the formula. Ppm is equal to mass of solute in gram divided by volume of solution in milliliter, and don't forget to write 10^6 in the multiplication of this formula. Okay, now let us put the values. Ppm is given 2.5 multiplied by is equal to mass. We are going to find the mass of solute multiplied by volume of solution, that is 5 multiplied by 10^3. 5000 is 5 × 10^3, and here don't forget to write 10^6. Now make the subject as mass of solute is equal to 2.5 multiplied by 5 × 10^3 divided by 10^6. And a subject banaviye to 2.5 na multiplication ma aavi jase aa અને ડિવિઝનમાં આવી જશે 10^6. નાઉ ધીસ ઇઝ ધી સિમ્પલ મેથેમેટિક્સ એન્ડ વી વિલ ગેટ ધી ફાઇનલ આન્સર. 25 × 5 = 125, એન્ડ ધેર વિલ બી અ ડેસિમલ પોઈન્ટ આફ્ટર વન ડિજિટ, સો ઇટ ઇઝ 12.5. નાઉ multiplied by 10 to the power 3 as it is, and if this 10 to the power 6 goes to numerator, then it will become 10 to the power minus 6. So our final answer will be 12.5 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 6 plus 3, that is minus 3, and what will be the unit? It will be gram, because this is the mass of solute in gram. So by using this formula, we can also find the mass of solute present in our solution if we have the value of ppm and volume of solution also. So this is very simple formula, very simple concept. All you have to do is, you just have to remember this formula of ppm. ppm is equal to mass of solute in gram divided by volume of solution in milliliter, and don't forget to multiply it with 10 to the power 6. It is not negative 6, it is positive 6. So, ane yaad rakhi liye, etla apru kaam thai jai. To aa tu ppm. Aa video ne ahiya pause kariye chhe. Next video ni andar apne navi concentration term ne sikhsu. To video like जरूर करो, तमने पसंद आवे એટલે એને લાઈક કરો, તમારા મિત્રોની વચ્ચે એને શેર પણ કરો, અને જો તમે નવા હો, હજી સુધી ચેનલ સબસ્ક્રાઇબ ના કરી હોય તો ચેનલ ને સબસ્ક્રાઇબ જરૂર કરો, બેલ આઇકન પણ પ્રેસ કરો. સારું, તો ટિલ વી મીટ નેક્સ્ટ ટાઈમ, હેવ અ નાઇસ ડે.